Welcome back to Virginia This Morning. This next guest is a lifestyle expert, an award-winning author, and host of the podcast Carpe Diem with Jasmine. In this segment, she talks with Evan, sharing her thoughts on the importance of self-care. Take a look.
After the last year that we've had, many of us are probably in need of some or maybe a lot of self-care. Our next guest is Jasmine Strenger. She is a lifestyle expert and a speaker, and she is here with some great ways that you can start your self-care journey. Good morning, Jasmine. Thank you so much for being here.
Good morning. Thank you so much for having me.
I love this topic, and I want to start by talking about, you know, how do you define self-care? I think so many people have different ideas, or they might think they know what it is, but how do you describe what it is that self-care is?
Yeah, I think you're right. There are a lot of misconceptions on what exactly self-care is. So many of us think that self-care is kind of like those external activities we do to take care of our body, whether it's like going to the gym, going to the hair salon, going to the spa, going to get our nails done, etc. But really, self-care is how we take care of ourselves, not only externally, but mentally too. The mental part is the component that I think a lot of people forget when they're talking about self-care. I have a bunch of tips here today for you, Evan. The first tip is like confidence. I think when we feel good about ourselves, when we're projecting confidence, that is a practice of self-care. And so I have a couple tips on how one, we can begin to feel more confident about our appearance. It always begins with appearance. You know, it's like if you're having a bad hair day, have you ever had a bad hair day and that affects your mood, or you get that pimple and you're like, oh my goodness.
Yeah, they say you look good, feel good, right?
Yes, exactly. Look good, feel good. So I begin every day and I go to bed with a moisturizing routine, and I love Olay Regenerous Whip. This is a 2-in-1 moisturizer with SPF 25. The one thing that I really like about it is that it goes on clear. It's super absorbent. I have found that it has helped with evening my skin tone. Another trick is I like to use a roller that I keep in the refrigerator kind of as a nighttime relaxation. So here I am, I'm getting some of that relaxation while taking care of my skin and even doing it in the morning. You can also dry brush. I use this sometimes. I'm like, I might brush a little harder, but I love the dry brush to get rid of dead skin. And then I just moisturize that. And sometimes when I'm brushing, I'm like, you know, I'm brushing off the bad vibes that I had from the day. I'm brushing off that Zoom call that didn't go well. I'm brushing off that mistake. So in a mental way, brushing kind of helps me alleviate some of my woes from the day. So the next tip is like hydration. I fail at this, but they say you should try to drink a gallon of water a day. I used to hear that you should drink your half of your body weight in water, but now the experts are saying that we should drink a gallon of water a day. I'm not there yet. But one of the things that I did take from when I used to go to the spa is creating what I call spa water. So every night before I go to bed, I fill up a pitcher with water. And today I have lemons and limes because I like that citrus flavor. Sometimes I put fruit, sometimes it's cucumbers and mint. And my goal is to try to drink this pitcher every single day, this whole pitcher of water. But the spa water is super easy to make and it's affordable. And another fun tip when I'm really not feeling it is like I pour my water in a fun glass instead of just doing a regular glass. You know, it's like, oh, maybe I am drinking something a little different, but no, it's just my spa water. I'm hydrating.
I love that. That is such a good one. It keeps it fun, keeps it interesting, and it's, you know, better than just plain water, right? Switch it up a little bit.
It's easy to do. I mean, and you can use what you have, like in your fruit basket at home.
Love it. Such a great one. And the next topic that we're going to talk about is reflection and introspection.
Yes. So I find that one of the things that people say that they would hope that they will carry out of quarantine with them is, you know, the time to reconnect with family, the time to reconnect with friends, and more importantly, the time that we have found to reconnect with ourselves. And I realize that, you know, we have kind of re-entered and things are picking back up and we're a little busier, but reflection and introspection is so important, not only as a for individuals, you know, for you and I, but for us to reflect with our children, reflect with our spouses. A couple ways that I recommend that people take time to reflect and be a little bit more introspective is with cards. I have tons of different card sets. So I love this one card set from With All. I'm gonna ask you a question. Evan, are you ready for your card? So we're gonna be
Okay. Okay, here we go.
It's conversation starters from With All. What's your favorite family tradition and why?
Ooh, that's a good one. I would have to say just everyone coming home from wherever we live at Christmas time, making the time, you know, one time a year at least to get together and know that that is the holiday that you're going to be spending together.
Right, yeah. And I love Thanksgiving. So,
yes.
Yeah, that's my favorite. But isn't it nice, just can you imagine doing this with your husband, doing it with your family, doing it with the kids, and getting their thoughts on, you know, a random topic? And you could do one card a day, you know, you could really work it out. I have mindfulness cards that are, you know, ask you to think, you know, may I be well? And it gives you an idea, a prompt to reflect on. I also wrote an award-winning book, if I do say so myself, that offers a lot of guidance on how we can really slow down and live more authentic, connected, and mindful lives. And it provides prompts from journaling and reflection. And if none of this fits your jam, get an old school journal and just journal your thoughts. Start with maybe, you know, you can find writing prompts on the internet, or you could start with what you're thankful for each day.
So many fantastic ideas. Jasmine, thank you so much for being with us and for sharing all of these. I think that this is really going to help a lot of people get on the path to self-care, something that is so important all the time, but especially right now.
It is. We have to take care of ourselves externally and, more importantly, internally.
Absolutely. Thanks, Jasmine.
Thank you.